It's just on like the first thing when you scroll down, you see kind of the images or videos. It just looks like a big R with a play button. And then you join it that way.
Oh, gotcha.
You see it?
Yep. All right, another join test. Can you see that?
What are you testing?
I just hit test on there. See if it popped up.
I have my window.
That's fine.
I have my windows all messed up. Hey, hey.
There's your wife saying I love you.
There's my wife. I love you, girl. Okay, so that puts the... let's see if I can just close out some things. And now the high tree. Miss Jackie, Scott, Tree, that's her husband talking to you like that from the church's page. That's not reflective of the opinions of all Redemption Peoria. Can y'all hear me? Or are you just typing to be polite? If anyone can hear me,
give a thumbs up.
Type.
Yes.
Yes.
Can hear. There's a thumbs up.
It's freezing kind of on my
end. Keep talking.
We'll keep waiting a little bit for people to jump on and make sure this works. As much as I've looked up all this stuff on how to do it, I still don't know what I'm doing. And I've heard that Facebook Live has been on the fritz today because all the church is trying to be themselves on Facebook, even though they're not themselves.
I said I can hear you.
Okay.
Sounds like a cathedral.
Sounds like a cathedral, dude. Well, it is a cathedral. This is my own personal bunker. Quarantining over here.
Your wife, what if someone wants to take the stairs?
Listen, we took care of it. It just means we'll have another visitor. I think there's a church somewhere in the vicinity recording a service as well, so you may get extra music. So on my computer, the comments are just delayed. I'm talking to John Demeter, by the way, who's sitting on the other end of the stairs, just in case you wonder.
What up?
I might have to let you just tell me stuff, John.
Yeah, it's just a little delay on my end.
It's a little delay. Okay.
All
right, we'll give it 3 more minutes. We'll call it 4 or 5. But how are you guys that are on here now? How are you doing? How's your family? How's your stress level? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see them probably at the end of this because it's delayed. I just still see, hey, Jay Demeter from Johnny.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, Eric Gifford in Oregon. My buddy, how are you? Oh, and there's all the people that said they could hear.
Right.
My kids are stressing me out.
Gosh, April.
Amen, darling.
Another step's a 15-second delay in Facebook Live.
Oh, thanks for that, buddy. I didn't know that. Well, then that won't matter to you guys. as much as it's mattering to me. So I'm gonna give it a couple more minutes and then we'll get cranking. Dr. James Ellis.
K.
Ellis. Hello, sir. Oh, hey, Miss Neely. Guys, the plan for this is to, much like this time that we're in, is to survive. If we don't get it right this time, I'll be back on Wednesday. Okay, and maybe I'll buy more equipment. Actually, I won't. I refuse to. The beauty of this stairwell is you don't need a whole lot. I hope that comes through as best as it can on a screen. That's not as personal as if I was telling it myself, but yeah. Hello, Danae and Ryan's family from California. It's cool. I've got some buddies on the East Coast. I don't know if they'll be coming or not, but I don't think it's just the Redemption Peoria crowd, which I'm excited about. I hope you guys are all doing well. All right, well, it's 4:05. I'm minimizing my Facebook screen. Here's kind of what we're going to do in these stairwell sessions. I'm going to give you a few disclaimers. Number one, this is not a live stream service in Redemption Peoria. A lot of people have asked me that, and that's not what this is. You're probably noticing sermon content is coming from a pre-recorded video via our YouTube channel. So you can search Redemption Peoria on YouTube and get on there. But this is not a live stream service at all. It's not going to feel like, well, it already doesn't feel like Sunday, but it's not meant to either. We're trying to embrace the uncomfortable. So I'm getting in that with you. It's the best way I can do. The goal for this really is to check in on you guys, to see how you're doing, and to remind you who's tuning in, whether you're a part of our congregation or not, that God is extremely good and ferociously holy and not at all surprised by anything or worried about anything for that matter. And that's good news to me. And it's really good news on days like yesterday when my kids all went insane, literally insane. But that's the goal of this. We're just going to sing. We're going to lift our voices. If it's awkward to you, because you're singing in your house with me on the screen, guess what? It's awkward to me that John Dimmer is sitting 3 feet away from me on the ground. Woo! And, yep, and that's awkward too. So, we're in the boat together. Let me read this to you. If you're on our worship team and you're joining, you know this, hopefully, by now. This is why we do anything that we do when it comes to lifting our voices in song to the Lord. This is Colossians 3. Verse 16, which says, "Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, teaching and admonishing one another in all wisdom, singing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs with thankfulness in your hearts to God." And so the goal of this time, each Sunday afternoon and Wednesday afternoon, is for that the word of God would dwell in us richly. And when that happens, because that word dwelling in us is living and active and not some old book that's not relevant anymore, it will change our hearts, it will shape our character, it will remind us who's in control and everything else that it's so great at doing. And so, I just want to read a few more scriptures and then we're just going to sing. I'm not going to talk much after that because I know that's kind of my deal, and I don't want to do that tonight. But I want to remind you of God's goodness, a few things during this time as we're practicing the social distancing, and I'd love to even just redefine social distancing. We're physical distancing. We can be more social probably than we are being right now. And to be honest, if you're any amount of time younger than me, you probably are kind of in a culture where everyone texts everyone. I would encourage you to call them, for crying out loud, and leave a voicemail if they don't pick up. Let them know you love them. Let them know you're thinking about them, if you are thinking about them, and ask them to call you back if they need anything. The other thing I wanted to share is if you're on this live stream and you go to our church, but maybe you're not friends with one another on Facebook, do that and get connected with people. See pictures of their kids on a daily basis and more of their real selves rather than here and there on the church page. And see if they have a need. We can take care of one another, and in doing so, we can come together and take care of a lot of people. And not just tangibly, but just it's good to know that people know who you are and who care for you. And so please do that. Reach out to people. There's a document, a form that we made for the church. If you're part of our church and you're local here in the Valley, you have a need, whether that be groceries or what it may be, or you know someone who's elderly that maybe can't get out, there's a link I want you to go to. If you want to help serve some of those folks that have needs, it's the same form. Or if you need some child care during this time if you're working at home, that's another thing on this form. The link is this. I'll try to type it in the comment if that's possible. I don't know if it is. But John maybe can do it. It's redaz.in/PEO_COVID-19, COVID-19. You click that link, it's going to open up a form. You can say, I'm in need. I know someone who's in need. I need child care. And I want to help those who are in need. And we've got folks that are monitoring responses on that form. Right now, we have a lot of people who say they want to help. And we don't have a lot of people saying they need help. So if you know people, pass it on. It's not just maybe a redemption thing, but you probably need to be in and around the Valley. I don't know that we can ship a whole lot to Oregon if Eric needs anything. But you can call me directly, Eric, if you need something, and I'll figure it out. Let me remind you of a few things. God's goodness. This is Matthew 10:29. It says this. This is Jesus talking. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? And not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. But even the hairs on your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, you are of more value than many sparrows. God is really, really good and cares for us. And he's quite aware of everyone's situation. Let me go to Romans here. God has unmatchless wisdom. He knows everything. He knows the best thing all the time. This is Romans 11:33-36. Oh, the depth of the riches and wisdom and knowledge of God. How unsearchable are his judgments and how inscrutable his ways. For who has known the mind of the Lord, or who has been his counselor? Or who has given a gift to him that he might be repaid? For from him and through him and to him are all things. To him be glory forever. Amen. I want you to think about God's goodness in the midst of the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. Romans 8:32, after 31 says, if God is for us, who can be against us? It reminds us that he who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? God gives us what we need. And then finally, before we sing, this is 2 Corinthians. You're probably familiar with this, 4:17-18. This is Paul writing a letter to the church, people who have been persecuted and who are being killed. And he reminds them of his own persecution, and he says, for this light momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. God is, in only the way that he can, wrapping up the most oddly packaged gift right now through a global pandemic, who doesn't care where you live and what your career path is and what your education is and what your ethnicity is. It's an opportunity for us to come together and remember that God's mercy and his love doesn't know any bounds. And we can rest in that today. So I'm going to sing some songs and some hymns, some spiritual songs per Colossians. And these are a lot of songs that we sing in our church. If you're not familiar with our church, these are a lot of them are old hymns of the faith. People much older and more dead than us singing songs and amidst a lot of affliction to the same Lord that is Lord right now. And so I pray you're encouraged by it. If this goes choppy or weird, we have no sound check much, and we have no way to test this. So stick with us. We'll try to be better on Wednesday. Same time, okay? Let me get a drink and we'll go. This hymn is Abide With Me by Henry Francis Lyte. And if you know anything about his life, he suffered great sickness, ultimately passed away from a severe illness, and wrote this hymn near the end of his life. And it's also, my wife said she wants me to play this at her funeral, as if I'm going to sing at her funeral, which is not going to happen. I'll just cry. But this is Abide With Me. They sing at soccer games in Europe, and they sang at Princess Diana's funeral, and it's a pretty big deal over there. But it's got good news for us today. It's called God Be a Lot of Great Jehovah. I think it's helpful for us during this time. Gift of grace is God giving us in the midst of COVID-19. a virus that no humans even had until now. Everyone's scrambling, doesn't know what to do. And there's no hot dogs at the store, y'all. And that's a big deal in my house. And to see people hoarding things, to see people hurting, see people's jobs being impacted, to see people's lungs being impacted, and their ability to be treated at all, and to see what I imagine is an immense amount, if this thing continues on and on and on like they probably think it will, the amount of loneliness I think this will reveal in so many of us, that we try to cover with so many things. And those things just don't cut it anymore, because we can't buy them, we don't have time because of the other things we need to do. What a gift of grace that might be, if we're willing to open that gift. Take care of your neighbor, take care of your family, take care of your vulnerable strangers that you don't even know. Give a dang about people and less about yourself. Tell that to me too, if I see you the next time or FaceTime in the next few days. It's called Yet Not I, But Through Christ in Me. It's a church in Australia, a music ministry called City of Light. And man, they're writing some good stuff for the church. I'm thankful for them. Says this, what gift of grace is Jesus my redeemer? There is no more for heaven now to give. He is my joy, my righteousness and freedom, my steadfast love, my deep and boundless peace. To this I hope, my hope is only Jesus, for my life is wholly bound to His. Oh, how strange indeed I can see all is mine, yet not I, but through Christ in me.
I know He will renew me.
wash. If we have time, you can't hold me to it because we're live. There's a song that I wrote a decade ago. Facebook gave me a memory last week. It was a decade ago, which is crazy. But I recorded it, and fairly appropriate, I think, for this time that we're in. If I don't get to it today, maybe Wednesday, maybe never. Again, that's just a terrible carrot to dangle. It ain't that good anyway, but I feel like I might need to share it. We need wisdom during this time. We need God to help us with remembering things like we've just sung, that He's in control, He's ruler over all things, all creatures, and He's guiding us, and He's given us His Son as the best gift we could ever get. He's in control, and whether we live or we die, whatever our fate may be, we can put our feet down collectively and declare to this, I hope. My hope is only in Him, nothing else. Not my health, not my job, not my mortgage, not anything, but in Him. We can take that to the bank, y'all. We need His wisdom. We need Him to give us vision. And so let's leave this hymn really quick. We'll see if we have time for that. Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me, say that thou art the my best.
Be still.
Peace.